Britain's most powerful motorsport, tractor pulling. For the largest indoor tractor pulling event in Europe at the enormous Sports Palais Ahoy. Fans are here from just about every country that's a member of the ETPC, which is the name of the controlling body in Europe. And they look like Cupmancy fans to me. That's Asterix hitching a lift round to the main arena. And as usual, we have two American teams here. One is in the two-wheel drive class. It's Bad Badger, driven by Dave Depper. And he's talking to Plain Ben Stream of Cloud 9. And you'll see later that they both have the same body shell for their machines. Now, before we get underway, let's go inside the arena to Michel Coy, who's ready with Tech Corner.
Hi, I'm Michel Coy from Tech Corner. Today's Tech Corner is about building pulling tracks. Here you see the concrete floor of the Ahoy Rotterdam Arena. It's a very hard concrete. Over there, you'll see the track, and it's a very special track. It's built from clay mixed with sand. About 35 truckloads of clay, it's about 500 cubic meters of clay, was driven into this arena, and it was built layer for layer. This means that they put the first layer in, it's about 5 centimeters thick, and then they roll it, and they compress it, and then they water it, till it's got the right water level. And then they put another layer on top of this layer. And so they built a whole track, and till they got approximately 40 centimeters of track, then they have the right pulling track. It's a very stiff, compressed pulling track. Here we see Leo Rademakers from Holland, the designer of this special tool, measuring the stiffness of the track. What you actually see is he is imitating the rear wheels of the tractor, and with this scale he can measure how much force he needs before the track breaks loose. On a very good track the scale runs to 18, on a very junky track the scale runs maybe to the start only. The material is only been used for tractor pulling. When the show is over, when the winners go home, they load the dirt in special trucks, they put it in a special storage, and they keep it there for next year. And this is the way it's been done for the last 10 years. This was Michel Coy from Tech Corner.
And that is the sledge or weight transfer machine moving back into place. You can see the white box at the end, which moves down the sledge to the front as they progress down the arena, making it harder and harder to pull. And the first event in the program is the 3.4-ton modifieds. 11 competitors from Holland, Germany, Great Britain, France, Belgium and the USA. The track, I'm told, is very good this year. After the test pulls last night, they say there's really good grip out there. Even though you use the same soil year after year, it can be wetter or drier, and that can affect the performance. First competitor is Green Monster from Germany, with Tobias Horskamp behind the wheel. He's Heinz-Josef's son, the owner of Green Fighter. Green Fighter, of course, the European 5.4-ton champion. So the German gets us underway, but his Allison V12 not running smoothly? Oh, he never really got going, and ends up just over halfway down the track, 36.88 meters for Green Monster. Now from Holland, this is Joep Wouters from Birmingham and Viper. He's a mechanic, he makes bakery equipment for a living, and Viper was 3-times Dutch champion back in the 80s. Their first real season up in the land of the modifieds. 7.6, so half a metre up on Viper. Very much a veteran fan. The BTPA cap badge would indicate he's from Britain. One or two coach loads of Brits normally come over to Ahoy, and I know Brian Armistead of Desperate Dan has a few of his friends with him as well. Right, this is Ali Cutts with 30-year-old Ad Boot from Dinterlore. He's got a single Allison. He had big clutch problems when we last saw him at Zwolle in January. Not very cleanly away there. You don't get those back wheels spinning from the start. You won't make the speed that's so necessary at the end of the pull. And that's that for the Ali Cutts. 49.04 would indicate he's still got a bit to do before he becomes a threat to the others. Now from France, this is Philippe Chouin and Synergy. He was third in the Europeans in Herbie in 95, but that was in the lighter 2.4-ton class with just two of these Turbo Mecha turbines. Always getting very close to the right edge of the track, but keeping it in with some heavy braking. Also comes up short, 56.52, and that is third place for Synergy behind Bandit and Viper. Rolling and raking the track, very important after each run, otherwise it would get very rutted at the end of the session. Now it's the turn of the first Americans, Dave Archer with Pioneer. Comes from Churchtown, Ohio, which is close to Marietta, which was the first settlement in the Northwest Territories. His own contracting company is also called Pioneer Pipe Incorporated. Oh, that's how it got his name, Pioneer. Four Chevy 557s with Littlefield blowers, and he was the American Grand National Champion in 1995. See what he can do here today. Oh, and he's really moving those wagons. Pioneer powers over for a full pull. Great run from the American. And a very fast time as well, I think. 8.51 seconds. See it again from our side camera. No messing from the 52-year-old American. Over and into a pull-off, which includes these tractors. Desperate Dan from Great Britain, even quicker than the American. And along with Terminator from Belgium, they must be the favourites to win. They've put extra weight on the sledge, and we're ready for the pull-off. And this is the first into the arena. Thunderbird from Holland with Kees Doornenboos from Groningen. Sitting behind four Rolls-Royce Gnome turbines, which come from Westland Wessex Helicopters. He's gone very well on recent runs. Can he keep up the good work? Oh, and there you can see, once the weight box moves to the front of the sledge, the diamonds dig in underneath. The tractor stops very, very quickly. 48.36 is the distance for Thunderbird. That's the second flag man, Wilfred Ensink, setting in the leader flag. Desperate Dan, they've just had two of their blowers back from the States, where they've been reconditioned. Boys from Blackpool anxious to start the season in top form. They won this class six times in a row in the European Championship, and they want to make it seven this year. Is he on his way to a second full pull? And judging by that, I would say about 5 metres to the 60-metre mark, wouldn't you? 54.52 to Desperate Dan, but he takes the lead. There are two enormous screens hanging from the ceiling, and the spectators here in Ahoy can see the pulls repeated in slow motion after each run. That was Klaus Wiedink, the commentator. He was introducing the next to pull, which is Asterix, with Henk Enderpol in the sun. We've just heard that Pioneer broke a blower belt on its first run and won't be coming out for the pull-off, so there are just three more to pull. Henk is a tractor driver from Vignard. And Asterix is a long way short of the leader. 41.05 gives him third place at the moment. And I guess it's the next team they've come to see. Beverel Egerbeaver from Holland. Jan van Diest from Putten is the man in charge. He's been pulling for 16 years. National champions in 1990, third in the Europeans in 93. He's got five Chevys, three injection and two blowers. And let's see if they can take the Beverel boys into the league. Thank you. second place. Yes, 45.23. If they've got their program up to date, they'll know there's just one more to pull, and that is Terminator 5 from Belgium. Rudy Paulus winding up the Isotov turbines, 54.53 to win. Albany's going off course and stopping very, very suddenly. 35.22 the distance, but overpressure in the left turbine has left oil on the track, and that means they're disqualified. So they get fifth place in the pull-off. So the result looks like this, a win for Desperate Dan from Thunderbird and Beverl Liga with Asterix fourth. So Jan, Brian and Case taking the cups and kisses, and it's time for us to meet the American guest Dave Depper of Bad Badger.
The Bad Badger, as some of the European pullers will know, looks a lot like Cloud Nine. Well, Cloud Nine got the body idea from me. He came over to the States and saw the Bad Badger and thought that was what he wanted, so we made an arrangement so that he could get a body like we have. My motor is a lot different. We have a called an AR Ford. It's a big aluminum block Ford engine built stateside, and it's a little different than what you run over here, but the truck is a lot like in the Cloud 9.
How does it compare as far as power is concerned?
We make about 2,000 horsepower, so we're probably a little more power than they are, but we weigh more too. We weigh 6,200 pounds, so maybe we're handicapped enough with weight that it should make good equal pulling.
How long have you been pulling in the States?
I've been pulling about 15 years. My son and I got started. I built a truck for him, a two-wheel drive truck for him, and went with him. And after doing that for a couple, 3 years, I said, he's having way too much fun. I got to have some of that fun. So I built another one.
And we'll be meeting Dave Depper again after a short break. The 3.4-ton Superstocks. There are two sessions, each packed out with 7,000 spectators. There you can see half of them. This long tube is part of a specially designed piece of equipment for extracting the exhaust fumes from the tractors. It's quite an ingenious design, really, and you'll better see how it works when the first tractors get coupled up. Dutch fan there, shaking the sand out of his clogs. And first to try his luck, Eric Meyer from Holland with Hurricane. Double European champion from 1995 in Herbie, but he had a quiet season last year. And there you can see the pipe covering the exhaust stack, and the humming sound comes from a powerful extractor fan that moves the exhaust outside. Well, most of it anyway. Hurricane struggling at the end there, not making a full pull, 54.8 meters his distance. Wilfried waiting for the next to be fitted to the sledge. And it's the return of an old friend, Thomas Patterson from Sweden, with Beer Addiction. He pulled in America last year, and he told me he attended 41 events and was in the prize money every time, which ain't bad going. There you can see the pipe is set on rollers, which easily follow after the sledge. Now here it is from our other camera. Thomas is just a whisker away from a full pull. 59.39, that takes the lead. But not for long if Red Alert has any say in the matter. Peter Clark is in the saddle, and the Case International Magnum 7250 is unleashed on this 60-meter long track. Powering all the way for a magnificent full pull, he really is hot. And that is what the British fans came to see. Really controlled power. The distance for the 60 meter dash, 8.61 seconds. That's the exhaust system being coupled up. Chain and the kill switch wire are also in place. And so is Martin van Echtelt on Silver Bullet. Martin coming from Houten, and a big task ahead of him if he's to equal Red Alert. On this occasion, Silver Bullet grounds at, let's see, 46.58 meters. Now, Christa Urn, the European 4.4-ton champion and mega power, rebuilt the engine with new pistons and rods. Oh, and he'll be back in the workshop after that run. Let's see it again in slow motion. A good start. Then he loses pressure, probably spurting oil on the hot turbos, creates the fireball, and that is that. Time now for the Inquisition and blowing out the fires that are left. Egger Herleby looking at the damage along with Krista. 24.53 is the distance. Now here's where the challenge to Red Alert could come from. Magcal Bits and Pieces with Leonard Griffin. That's the owner and co-driver, Willem Beldhausen, nervously pacing about. Their practice last night went well. Front wheels high in the air, they look very impressive. And it looks like same again. Oh, but then after 40 metres, something broke, and Magcal is in bits and pieces. Here's the slow motion repeat. Thrusting skywards with the front wheels. Too high, really, to get the best traction. Seem to be cruising, and then drops like a stone within sight of a full pull. 55.94 into third place for the John Deere. This is European 3.4-ton champion Pekka Herlevi and Delta Power. Well, that was him. Krista's turn to commiserate. 1.5 metres for the second Valmet. And again, piston problems, and he struck oil there. And Pekka looks pretty peeved. Watching it on the big screen. And now a rare sight, a John Deere painted red. Roughneck has a new sponsor, and it's now called Kofo Power Roughneck. And that little Sunday drive didn't get very far. 5.22, so not a good debut for Henk Melnik. We have two more to pull, and this is Zappo, looking very smart. Let's see if he can live up to his looks. Building up the revs. Quite an impressive run this. Yes, 57.57 gives him third place. Just one to pull, and Peter Clark wondering if he's going to start the new season with a victory. Here's the one who could stop him. Heart of the Eagle, driven by Rob van der Waal from Crimpen and Black. Runs on alcohol, so it doesn't need the extractor machine. But that won't get him in the top three. Just about over 50 metres, I think. 51.3, sixth place for Heart of the Eagle. And a final result which looks like this. Red Alert, the only full pull, with the Swede Thomas Patterson signalling he's back with second spot. Next up is the two-wheel drives, and we'll talk to Bert Hoeghoegel of Predator.
Predator is a unique tractor. It's unique because it looks like a Volkswagen Beetle. We chose for the Beetle look to get a European identity, and we did it well, I think, because it's a very popular two-wheel drive. The tractor looks friendly, but it's got a strong engine. It's a 1500 horsepower engine. It's a Chevrolet Merlin 7.8 liter and V8s. Last season was not a super season for us in Holland, but in Holland we became number 4. But strange but true, we won most of the matches abroad, and in Germany we always perform good. We hope that it's gone a good season for us. We have changed the engine, and we hope to win a lot of matches here in Holland.
And it'll be interesting to see how he performs today. But first, to clip on and couple up, is Rattle and Hum, driven by Ilko van Putten from Dronten. He's one of 8 contestants in this class, with Bad Badger the star. Away from a full pull, 59.58 the distance, and you need strong legs and shoulders to be an ice cream salesman here at Ahoy. Now Bad Badger, Dave Depper was telling me the badger is the state symbol for Wisconsin, where he comes from. He bought the two-wheeler from Chris Holdorf, who lived in Florida, and then it was called the Gator. When he was driving back, a trucker passed him, and they talked on the CB radio, and he said, "That's one bad gator you got there." And Dave said, "Well, we're on our way to Wisconsin." And the trucker said, "Well, that's one bad badger." That's how he got his name. Oh, he was right. That is a mean machine. 300 or 400 200 extra horsepower than the others in Europe. The most Dave Depper saw with that run was the people on the first row of the balcony. He was so high. Over for a full pull. And 8.95 seconds is the time. Six others in the pull-off. They're led by Sledgehammer, who set fastest time over the 60 metres, even faster than Bad Badger, in fact. So this is going to be an interesting pull-off. And it's Sledgehammer who will lead the way. Jan Luendijk has spent the winter putting a new Chrysler Hemi into his machine. Certainly paid off in the first run. Really going well. Cost him about 18,000 for the engine. And it could already start paying dividends today. Bouncing to the rest about 10 metres short of a second full pull. 49.76 the distance for Sledgehammer. Really impressive in slow motion. High, wide and handsome. You can see why they call this class the two-wheelers. Anyway, Wilfried putting the marker post in. And no limit backing up to the sledge. Did well at Zwolle in January. Can Gerard Jonkman find the same form again? See, they have a very interesting configuration. The 468 Chevy is behind the driver. It's the only one in this class. And it's fitted with a 1071 Littlefield blower. So, no limit, about to be pushed to the limit. 49.76 to take the lead. But that is just a little too short. 48.25 for no limit. Sensible lady, earrings and earplugs, because the noise at times is almost unbelievable. Now this nice bodywork is the property of Butterfly Morning. Had a lot of fires and problems with the engine that they bought from Heartbeat last season. Wonder if they've finally got it sorted. Dividing partition between the engine and the driver's cab, so he hasn't really burnt his toes in there. And you know, he's still about the same distance as No Limit. 48.32 gives Butterfly Morning second place, 7 centimeters more than No Limit, but behind Sledgehammer. Now the Black Beauty, known as Miss Liberty, owned and driven by Michel Coy, our tech corner man. They've just fitted a brand new Chrysler Hemi Max, and Ahoy is the first run. So they're a bit nervous that things will go well. Looked very smooth in the earlier quali. See if he can repeat that form now. Ooh, not going very well this time. I guess he's having some teething problems. Stopping very abruptly could spell trouble when he looks inside the engine. 40.10 for Miss Liberty. Three more to pull. Cloud 9 there, building up the revs. A new Chevy 427 with the Enderley fuel injection. They want to impress their American guests. Oh, and they're doing that. A great run. Well past Sledgehammer. He may well have gone over for a full pull. It's very close. I think that's a victory salute. Not a white flag there. 10.96 his time. Full pull, about 1.5 seconds slower than when he qualified. So that is our new leader. This is Predator with Boot Hawk Hordle. Needs a full pull to force Cloud 9 out again. I don't think he's got the forward speed. No, he makes about 50 metres. 49.41, so into third place, 36 centimetres short of Sledgehammer in second place. Now finally, Bad Badger, the last to pull, the most powerful. It's only a demo anyway, but it's always a pleasure to welcome the Americans when they come over. Not so high this time, more a controlled power pull, and burning off some fuel there at the end. Officials rushing in all directions looking for an extinguisher, but Dave Depper doesn't appear to be worried. A full pull and quicker than Cloud 9. And here's the official result. Cloud 9 winning the Super Pool. Bad Badger with a more powerful engine just running to show the public what it can do. Bert Plin and Jarl enjoying their moment in the spotlight. We'll take a break. We'll be back with the evening session after this. In Rotterdam for the second session of the European Super Pool. Both sessions opened this year with a big firework display and it's set to music. Quite impressive. Here today, 16-year-old Gert van der Land, who of course is still at school. Gert accompanied here by his father and sister, they seem to go to all the pools and today is no exception, which is what his mini's called. Irresistible. With eight more to pull and mini break Baker, who came all the way down here from Norway, he can't come to the start. They've damaged the steering. So a long journey for nothing for them. But this is Gompie. Rennie de Bruyn is in the hot seat from Maasland in Holland. It's a Rover Meteor V12. And he was very, very close to a full pull there. It's the longest so far, 56.46 for Gompie, who takes the lead. That was the slightly singed mascot of the Turbine called Landy, and Dirk Veenstra. He won the Eurocup rounds at Bernay and Herning last year, and looked really impressive, but then Dirk has gone through a lean patch of late. Oh, and he's definitely down on power today. And lots of steam at the end. Short on distance as well. 50.07 for Landy. This is Vampire with the only star motor in the field. It's an Alvis Leonidas Major 14-cylinder and 800 horsepower job. But he got off well. Flying start, you might say. But when the going got tough, the tough stopped. 45.12 for Benny Vreeman and Vampire. Five more to go. Gompie still in the lead. No full pulls. Either they're all down on power or they've been rather tight with the sledge setting. Now it's the turn of ZZ Top with Frank Verboven. It's his new Mini. Introduced it last season after running for several years with Stubborn Sister. Got a Rodec 540 with a Mercedes rear axle. And he really means business. Really going for it. Is over for our first full pull. ZZ Top goes to the top. Full pull to Frank Verboven, and the 7,000 crowd giving him the applause he deserves. And when you see two Rolls-Royce gnomes, you know that Garcon Problem Charlie is backed up to the sledge. Getting close to out of bounds. Oh, and then his front wheel bops on the chalk line, and that's it. Disqualification for Garcon Problem Child. Better the next time, Henry. Three more to pull, and they include two former European champions. Here's one of them, Joker with Thomas Zimmermann from Effenscheiss. This is a determined run from the 22-year-old. Oh, but just a fraction short of the 60-meter line. What bad luck, Thomas. 58.59 for Joker, and that's second place with two to run. And that's Hubert Schwartz, the third brother in the Ghostbuster team. And this time, it's Ghostbuster 1, driven by Eugen Schwartz. Won the European Championship crown in 1993 in Herning in Denmark. Like Gompie, it's a Rolls-Royce Meteor engine. And unlike his brother, he storms over for a full pull. So ZZ Top has got company. We have a pull-off. Now the last to pull, Lambada 4. That's Gert looking back to his younger brother, Wim Dingerich Jr., who's back at the start, waiting for the off. Second twice and third three times in last year's Eurocup with Gert behind the wheel. That's Dirk Veenstra on the end there, following the action. Third place. Dave Depper and his wife Jan watching. Gert looking up to the scoreboard. He seems happy enough. Let's go up to the scoreboard ourselves. 59.30 and third place for Lambada 4. So we have a pull-off. Won't take too long to read. ZZ Top against Ghostbuster 1. And the German the faster of the two by 34 seconds. It's Frank Verboven who's first away. Holland versus Germany. Frank going well again. That was another splendid run from the Dutchman. 57.5, and that is a tough target to beat. Or is it? The Ghostbuster boys never give up. They have masses of experience. The Meteor motor has served them well over the years. For the past 9 months, it's been Eugen who's done the driving. 57.51 to win. But Ghostbuster doesn't do it. 57.3. And that means he'll have to settle for second spot. Here's the official result. Holland 1 and 3 with the Germans 2 and 4. And Gompy underlining that third in Jerva was no flash in the pan. Caroline, Ellie and Shani handing out the kisses and flowers, and Frank Verboven back on top with ZZ Top. Well done. In the past they've had singers to entertain in the break. This time it's Motorsports Team Seiss. Four youngsters, Frank, Franz, Tim and Anouk. She's the only girl. And I hope they don't let him loose in the car park. They've been going for 8 years and they perform all over the world. See, there's no saddle there, so they have to stand. The bikes are called Gas Gas and they come from Spain if you're interested. What a smart little cyclist. The Dutch cyclist really entertaining the crowd. We'll take a break now. We'll be back with the 4.4 ton modifieds after this. Damn right, it's time for us now to meet one of the American guests, Dave Archer from Pioneer. And I asked him how he found time to go tractor pulling.
Well, it's pretty hard. We're a contractor. We employ about 450 people doing industrial contracting in the chemical plants in the Ohio Valley. And in the summertime, it's very difficult. A lot of sleepless nights. But we decided about 7 years ago that we were going to go out and have a little fun before we retire.
And how many events do you normally do in the States?
We normally do between 35 and 45 events each year. We'll be building a new tractor next year, a new four-motor tractor to take the place of this one, so we may do a few more.
Over here in Europe, we're starting to see that there are a lot of turbines coming on the scene. Have you got so many in the States?
We haven't got so many, but the Walsh brothers, who had dairies last year, building a new turbine tractor. Art Arpons is helping them this year, and a couple smaller ones are being built. But it's a coming thing in the States. I think we'll see more of them in the years to come.
Thanks, Dave. He's doing a demo run now, but he only runs in the lighter class normally, so he only came over with four engines, and there's no place for extra weights. So he's both light and underpowered for his class, but he's giving it a shot. All the last 10 meters, really hard going. You can see the 60 meter mark in the foreground, so Dave's about 8 meters short of the full pull. 53.27 for Pioneer from Marietta. The cameraman chatting up Dave's daughter Kathy. That's one for the scrapbook. Obviously a lot to talk about. And this is Viper. On with the kill switch wire. If anything goes wrong, the sledgeman can stop the run by pulling the wire, and that kills the electrical system and stops the engines. Seventh this afternoon. It'll be hard put to improve on that. Miss the heavier class. 15 to the start in this class. But Joep Wouters will do his best, you can be sure of that. Ooh, sliding over to his left. And he drops down well under 50 meters. Yes, 44.55 to Viper. And I'm afraid that won't win him any medals today. Now from Germany, the veteran from near Stuttgart, Eugen Kiemeler and Museums Killer. Both Killer and Cat are up for sale, if anyone has a big enough check. Band members taking a break from blowing and banging. And Eugen winds up his RS engines. Smoke at the end, and Killer dies with a shorter distance than Viper. European champion at this weight in 92, and only 42.38 on this run. Now, Asterix, who's fourth this afternoon, but not really enough weight or power to be a real force in this class. Henk all up against other heavyweights like Q18 Popeye, Green Spirit and Ik Koopmanschi. And he slides over to his left, but he manages to bring it back on course. And then his rear wheel locks up. 49.77 for Asterix. And there you can see, that's enough to stop anyone, let alone when you're hitched to a sledge. Now that's Jan Groenstein backing up with Super Casper. Shares the driving with his brother Gerard. She's a regular, has the same seat year after year, and she always gives us a wave.
It's almost impossible to tell from this angle. There's the flag.
47.74, exactly half a metre better than the Dutchman. So the Brits in the lead. Can Fox from Denmark do better? This is Peter Larsen's last drive. He just doesn't have the time anymore. So from the summer, they have Flemming Smed behind the wheel. He's one of their regular mechanic helpers. They're also rebuilding Fox, so it'll be completely new in the summer. Torben, the mechanic, told me they'll have run 100 times during the past 2 years without rebuilding an engine. So they're just happy to be in the pull off the door. So Peter Larsen's final four. Is he going to round it off with a win? Metres after the leader, so Desperate Dan has just three more to worry about. It's after midnight now, so it's been a very, very long session. 45.03 for Fox. And it could be a lucky session for Jan van Alphen and Q8 Team Popeye. They won this afternoon's 5.4 ton class. Now they're going for the double. Three Allison V12s are his power source. This looks promising. Yes, he's past Desperate Dan. Up goes his arm in triumph. And that could well be our winner. The Popeye fans on their feet doing a jig. 49.77. That's over 2 meters up on Desperate Dan. And Jan is already celebrating. And I can understand why. I don't think the last two have the power to get close. But anything can happen in tractor pulling. This is the first of the challenges. Oregon 2, driven here today by Christoph Lawney. His brother Freddy normally drives, but he fell off the tractor lorry a week ago and he broke his leg. He's here today, but he's a bit handicapped. And Oregon and its two Griffins not quite up to the job, well down on the leaders. There's Freddy. Always in good humour. 35.22 his distance. 7th place at the moment with 1 to run. Oregon out into the night. Jan van Alphen waiting for the prize giving. And here's the only one who could deny him 1st place. Keith Doornenbos and Thunderbird. Always reminds me of a big central heating system, this tractor. Second this afternoon in the 3.4s, he's shown he's really getting his act together. Winding up the revs. But this is too big a mouthful to chew. And he is well down. 36.59 for Thunderbird, and that gives him 7th overall. But Q8 does the double. He wins the 5.4 and then takes the 4.4 in convincing style. Maybe he should do the Eurocup this year. Try and improve on his 3rd place from last year. And while they do, let's look back at the top places in the earlier 4.4 ton superstock class in the pull-off. This is Gerrit Esselink with Hurricane. Now he's losing the speed. About 5 meters too short of a full pull. 55.56 for Hurricane. And that's Anouk, the motorcyclist, exhausted by her exertions. Next to pull, Makkal Bits and Pieces. They've had problems with the pump in their power braking system, which means it's difficult to steer. All drifting off to his left. And that was very, very close. Leonard Griffin shutting off before he goes out of bounds. 46.88 the distance. Now Red Alert. Also going for the double. Fastest qualifier. Really flying today. Peter Clark is hungry for success. Maybe this will satisfy his hunger. A second full pull. So Red Alert took the lead. Then there was just Thomas Patterson that could stop him doing the double. Dear Addiction with a punctured right front wheel. Second in this afternoon's lighter 3.4 ton class. And it looks like he's going to be second again. That was another pull from the Swede, 57.46, so Gerrit, Peter and Thomas on the podium, and here's the official result. Clearly Red Alert is going to be the one to beat in the season to come, but I expect Magcal Bits and Pieces to be a threat when they sort out the technics. Another podium presentation, this time the two American guests, Dave Depper and Dave Archer, up with their families, who have some souvenirs to take back with them. Very impressed with Ahoy. Even they don't have big screen presentation in the States. And finally, here's where to write to for further info, or you can surf there like 12,000 others have done so far on the internet. Well, that's it from Ahoy. This is Roger England saying bye for now.